Hi guys, and welcome to the third episode of EatTheBlocks. Today we're going to deploy our smart contract to a local testnet with Web3. So first we're going to start our local testnet. So in the previous episode, we already installed the npm package, but if you haven't done so yet, you need to install it. So it's npm install global and then Ethereumjs-testrpc. I already have it, so I need to reinstall it. Then, once it's installed, you will launch it with testrpc. And once it's launched, it's running on localhost port 8545 and it creates 10 accounts here. You see all the addresses and you can use any of those accounts and they all come preloaded with some Ether. Keep in mind that this is a virtual, some fake Ether just on your local testnet. So you can spend it, use it, it doesn't have any importance. Now open another terminal window and you will need to clone the GitHub repo of EatTheBlocks to access the source code of the HelloWorld contract that we created during the previous episode. So you will need to do a git clone, then the URL of the repo. I will copy this URL in the episode description below the video. And once you've cloned this repo, you need to go to the episode 3 folder and there will be a helloworld.sol file. So you need to have this file in the same folder as you will execute your node session. Let's have a look at this HelloWorld smart contract that we created during the previous episode. So we're going to cat helloworld.sol. So here we have our constructor function, which is the function will be executed when the contract will be created. So it accepts a variable my message of type byte32, so it's basically a string. And this variable will be affected to an internal variable, which is called message. And it also has a getMessage method. Okay, so that is what we will deploy to our local testnet. Open another terminal window and we will need to install two npm package. So the first one is called Web3. It's a client for the Ethereum network. So you install it with npm install Web3. And another package that you need to install is solc, which is the compiler for Solidity, solc. I already have both of those packages, so I don't need to install them. Then, once you've installed those two packages, you can start your node session by typing node. Then you are inside the node session. So first you will need to import those two npm packages. So let's start with Web3. So var Web3 with a capital W require Web3. Next, we're going to import the compiler, so Solidity compiler, so require solc. Next, we're going to connect to our local testnet. So for this, we're going to create a new variable, Web3. New Web3, so careful because this Web3 here is with a capital W because we're referring to this global Web3 object. The Web3 with a lowercase w will be our connection instance. So those are two different things. Then you open the parentheses and you need to specify a provider. So web3.providers.http provider. So a provider is a way to connect to the Ethereum network because there are many ways to connect to Ethereum. So here we specify that we're going to connect using HTTP and then we type localhost 8545, which is the host and the port of our local testnet. Okay, close the parentheses. Close the second parenthesis. Okay, seems to be right. Enter. Then we need to compile our smart contract with solc. So we're going to do this. with var compile contract equal source C compile. And here we're going to use the FS module of node to read into memory our file, and we're going to use the method read file sync, which is more convenient to use. And then we're going to specify the path to our file, so it's hello world.sol. And then you're going to transform it to a string. Okay, and it should work. And now we're going to extract two things from this object. The first thing we're going to extract is called the ABI, or another name that people use is interface. It's basically a description of what are the functions in the program and how they can be called. So let's extract this. So we're going to reuse this variable that contains all the information. So compile contract, and then dot contracts, which is an array of all the contracts that were in this file, because in a single Solidity file you can have many contracts, so we need to specify which one we want. Then we open the bracket and we need to specify the key, so all the contracts are prefixed with a colon, and our contract is called hello world. Then we need to close the bracket, and for this contract we want the interface. Okay, it works. Now we want another thing from this compile contract object. We want the bytecode, which is the a string that represents all the instruction of the program in a format that can be understood by the EVM, which is the Ethereum virtual machine. So we're gonna store this in another variable that we will call bytecode. Okay, so now we have everything we need, so we will finally be able to create our contract object with Web3. So we're going to create a new variable that we're going to call hello world, and this variable will be an object that will be built with web3.eth.contract. And we're gonna specify an argument, which is the ABI. But if we just do it like this, we're gonna have a problem, you will see. Okay, so it doesn't work because, let's see the error. You must provide the JSON interface of the contract when instantiating a contract object. Okay, So what did we do wrong? Because we did specify the interface, but the problem is that this method expects a JSON object, but we specify a string. So we need to pass this string into a JSON object. So we can do this very easily with JSON pass. It's gonna convert this string into a JSON object that JavaScript understand and can manipulate. So let's try again. Okay, and this time it has worked. So now that we have this contract object, we can create a transaction object. So let's define another variable, hello world transaction. And we're gonna build this transaction object from our contract object. So hello world. And we're going to use the method deploy. And this deploy method is going to take an object as an argument. And one of the key of this object is the bytecode of the contract under the key data. So data, which will receive the bytecode string that we've produced before with the source C npm package. And let's see if this enough. No, it's not going to work. We're still missing an argument. Let's see. Okay, we're still missing something. Error here. Invalid number of parameters. Okay, so we haven't specified the parameters. So let's go back to our command. And after data, we also need to specify the parameters with which we want to create this contract. So parameters. And if you remember, for this this contract, the constructor expects one parameter of type byte 32. It's basically a string. So we can put whatever we want inside. So say hello, for example. Okay. And now he should, oops, it's not a double quote, it's a simple quote. And we need to put this in an array because a constructor method can accept several arguments. So the first argument will be the first entry of the array, the second argument, the second entry, etc. Okay, so now if I type enter, it should successfully create this transaction object. Still not. Oh, it's not parameters, it's it's arguments, maybe. Yes, it was arguments. Okay. So it works. Cool. Finally, we will be able to deploy our contract from this transaction object. So let's do this. So hello world transaction. And we can call a method called send. And this method expect an object with a key from that specify the account from which this transaction will be made. Indeed, transactions cost money, and we will need to pay with some of our fake Ether. So we need to specify the account that's going to pay. So fortunately for us, the local testnet has created some already preloaded account. So let's switch back to our other terminal window. And we can just copy the address of one of the 10 accounts. So I right-click, copy, and I go back to the other terminal window. I copy my address as a string. And then I still need to specify another parameter, which is gas. So gas basically is a measure of how much computation is my smart contract is allowed to consume. We're going to explain in the next episode in more detail what gas is, but basically it's like a hard limit where I say, okay, at most I'm willing to pay this many gas. So let's try a random number like 10,000, for example, and we're going to see what happens. Okay. And this is going to produce, return a promise. So we will catch this promise with a then. And in this then, we're going just to console log the result. Okay. So let's press enter and see what's the problem. So given parameter here is not bytes. Okay. So the type of argument in our smart contract constructor is bytes 32, but what we provided is not a bytes 32. So in order to solve this problem, we need to rebuild the transaction object when we specify the kind of argument here. And instead of directly providing the string, we need to transform the string into something else that is compatible with the bytes 32 type. So for this, we're going to use a utility function of Web3. So Web3 utils, and it's called ASCII to X. And this function is going to take as an argument our hello string, and it should be okay. So now we've rebuilt our transaction object, and we can deploy it on the blockchain. Okay, so hello world transaction send. We've specified the account. We've specified the amount of gas, and then we console log the result. So it should work, but you will see that there is still another problem. Okay, now we have another problem. So let's scroll up to see what's the error message. Unhandled rejection error. Base fee exceed gas limit. Okay, so basically we've specified a maximum number of gas that this contract can use for to be deployed, but unfortunately it requires more gas. So how do we know how much gas we need? So first we're going to clear our screen. Okay, so now we're going to use a function that allows us to estimate the amount of gas that the deployment of a transaction would cost. So let's type Web3f estimate gas, and we're going to pass this function our transaction object. So it's hello world tx, and we're going to catch the result with a then console log. And we see that the estimation is 53,000 here. Okay, so let's try to redeploy our transaction with this amount of gas. Okay, so 53,000. And it still doesn't work. Okay, so the error is still exactly the same, not enough gas. So in this case, the estimate gas function didn't work properly. The estimation of gas is not correct. Sometimes it doesn't work. So when this is the case, we just have to increase randomly the amount of gas and see what kind of amount could work. So let's do this. So let's change back the gas amount to something bigger, like maybe we can try 1 million. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And it works. And here we see that the address of the deploy contract is the highlighted string here. So if we go to the terminal window where our testnet runs, we will see that we receive a send transaction RPC call here. And we see that it created the contract here. And if we copy this string and we compare it to what we got from the Web3 object, it should be the same thing. Yes, it's the same thing. Great, we successfully deployed our Hello World smart contract to our local testnet. In the next episode, we're going to see how to send a method call to this smart contract and what's the concept of gas and gas price. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, and if you like this episode, please subscribe and share. Bye-bye.